Days after some sections within the Congress questioned the absence of an elected party chief, Sonia Gandhi today asserted that she is a full-time, hands-on party president and leaders need not speak to her through the media. Her remarks came after some leaders of the Group of 23, including Kapil Sibal, who had sought organizational overhaul, recently questioned who in the Congress was taking decisions in the absence of a full-time party president. Congress leader Rahul Gandhi today during the CWC meeting said that he will consider returning as Congress president. According to a report, it emerged that several senior leaders, including the chief ministers of Punjab, Rajasthan and Chhattisgarh, as well as former defense minister A.K. Antony, urged the Wayanad member of parliament Rahul Gandhi to come back. Chhattisgarh Chief Minister Bhupesh Baghel has announced the compensation of Rs 50 lakh for the family of the man who died after a speeding vehicle ran over Durga Puja devotees in Chhattisgarh's Jaspur on Friday. Reports say 15 other people were injured in the accident. "I pray for the speedy recovery of the injured," Chief Minister Baghel said. China is demanding $38 million from Pakistan as compensation for 9 Chinese engineers killed in a bus blast in July this year. The bus was carrying more than 30 people to a hydropower plant site in the remote Upper Kohistan region. China has said that it was a deliberate bombing. However, Pakistani officials blamed a mechanical failure. ISKCON temple and devotees were violently attacked by a mob of over 200 people in Noakhali, Bangladesh. "Temple suffered significant damage," ISKCON tweeted, adding, "We call on the government of Bangladesh to ensure the safety of all Hindus and bring the perpetrators to justice." The body of a devotee was found in a pond next to the temple. 95-year-old monarch Queen Elizabeth was heard on a microphone criticizing world leaders' inaction on climate change as she opened the Welsh Assembly in Cardiff on Thursday. In an apparent dig at those not attending the upcoming COP26 climate summit, the Queen said, "Still don't know who's coming to the summit. It's really irritating when they talk, but they don't do." After 16 years, Sir Elton John reclaimed the top spot in the UK singles chart with his new single, Cold Heart, which is a collaboration with singer Dua Lipa. With this, Elton has become the first artist with a top 10 single across 6 decades. Elton John's first single to top the chart was Don't Go Breaking My Heart in 1976.